नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। आई जेवियन प्रीति सिंह, फैकल्टी ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ, वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी। टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक फिजिको केमिकल एंड बायोलॉजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ कंट्रोल ड्रग डिलीवरी सिस्टम। सो दिस टॉपिक्स बिलोंग्स टू द नॉवेल ड्रग डिलीवरी सिस्टम थ्योरी फॉर द बी फॉर्म 7th सेमेस्टर। Now the physico-chemical properties of a drug influencing drug product design and performance. Aqueous solubility, drug must be in solution to be absorbed. Drug with very low aqueous solubility suffer from oral bioavailability due to limited gastrointestinal transit time of the undissolved drug, limited solubility at the absorption site. Unfortunately, many drugs have less solubility at the site of absorption. Example, tetracycline dissolved greatly in the stomach than the intestine, but the absorption is maximum in the intestine. Absorption is limited due to dissolution rate, digoxin, warfarin, and greasofulvin, salicylamide. So the aqueous solubility influences drug dissolution rate, which in turn establishes its concentration in solution. So the dissolution rate is given by Noyes-Whitney equation under sink condition. dC by dt is equal to kd ECCS. dC dt dissolution rate and kd dissolution rate, and A is the surface area of the dissolution solution. So the CS is saturation solubility of the solid. So the aqueous solubility limit that the loading efficiency of carriers, water soluble drugs leak out from the carriers. So the particle size mainly affects solubility, which in turn affect dissolution, and particle size is less than surface area is more, and hence more dissolution and more absorption. Example, greasofulvin and nitrofurantoin and spironolactone and procaine penicillin. So the partition coefficient, it is the ratio of fraction of drug in an oil phase to that of an adjacent aqueous phase. So the drugs with high partition coefficient are predominantly lipid soluble and have very low aqueous solubility. So the particle coefficient and molecular size influences permeation of drug across biological membranes, diffusion across rate controlling membrane. So the diffusivity, ability of drug to diffuse through membranes called as diffusivity, and log D is equal to minus SV log V plus KV is equal to minus SM log M plus KM. D is equal to diffusivity and M is equal to molecular weight and V is equal to molecular volume, and SV, SM, KM, KM are the constant. So the drug stability, drugs given by oral route may undergo acid-base hydrolysis and enzyme degradation, gut wall metabolism. And so a fifth is protein binding. Drugs bind with plasma protein, albumin, which results drug retention in the vesicular space. Drug protein complex can serve as a reservoir. Main forces for binding are van der Waal forces, hydrogen bonding, and electrostatic forces. Charged compound has greater tendency to bind protein than uncharged ones. So the example is amitriptyline and diazepam, and diazepoxide have 95% protein binding. So the polymorphism, a solid can exist crystalline or amorphous form when a substance exit in more than one crystalline form. The different form called as polymorphs, the phenomena polymorphism. Polymorphs differ in their physical properties such as solubility, melting point, density, hardness, and compression characteristics. So the changes of one form to another form affect the bioavailability in tablet preparation affect flow properties. So the biological factors influencing design and performance of sustained control products. So the biological half-life is aim of oral sustained release product is to maintain therapeutic blood level over an extended period of achieve this drug must enter in blood at approximately the same rate at which it is eliminated. So the elimination rate is quantitative described by half-life T half is equal to 0.693 upon K and T half is equal to 0.693 V upon CL. K is equal to first order elimination rate constant, V is equal to apparent volume of dissolution and CL is equal to systemic clearance. Drug with half-life shorter than 2 hours are poor candidates and furosemide levodopa. So the drug with the long half-life more than 8 hours not use digoxin and phenytoin, warfarin, diazepam. GI transit time mouth to ileocecal junction is 8 to 12 hours. If absorption takes place in colon, then 24 hours. So the absorption is the for sustained release doses form. Rate of release is much lower than rate of absorption. And the transit time of drug upon device is about 8 to 12 hours. Maximum absorption half-life should be 3 to 4 hours. This corresponds to a minimum absorption rate, constant Ka, of 0.15 hours to 0.23 hours for 80 to 95% absorption over this period. Drugs with low absorption rate constant are poor candidates. So a drug is absorbed by active transport or limited to specific region of the intestine may not be suitable. Example, ferrous sulfate. And absorption is maximum is duodenum and jejunum. But the doses form low density pellet and capsule or tablet is retained in the stomach, allows the slow release of the drug. Example, p-aminobenzoic acid and increased gastric retention result and higher blood levels. Another approach using bioadhesive material is example, pilocarpine absorbed across the cornea about 1% from applied dose. A sustained release product improve bioavailability, example Ocusert. So the distribution, elimination of drug dependent on its distribution. Two parameters are used to describe distribution pattern, apparent volume of distribution and TP ratio and ratio of drug concentration in tissue to that in plasma at the steady state and drug follow one compartment model, VD is equal to dose upon C naught. So C naught is initial drug concentration immediately after intravenous bolus injection, but before any drug has been eliminated. So the drug follows a two compartment model, VSS is equal to 1 plus K12 upon K21 square bracket close is V1. So V1 is the volume, the central compartment, and K12 is the rate constant for distribution of drug from the central to the peripheral compartment. K21 is that from the peripheral to the central compartment. V13 drug concentration in the blood or plasma at a steady state to the total amount of drug in the body during repetitive dosing or constant rate infusion. If amount of drug in the central compartment P is non-drug in the peripheral compartment T and total amount of drug in the body can be calculated. TP upon the K12 and K21 beta. K12 is the rate constant for distribution of drug from the central to the peripheral compartment. So K21 is from peripheral to the central compartment, and beta is the slow disposition rate constant. So now we come to the metabolism. So the metabolism is biochemical transformation in which active form of drug is converted to inactive form or vice versa to areas of concern, and ability of drug to induce or inhibit enzyme synthesis, which results in fluctuating drug blood level with chronic dosing, fluctuating drug blood level, and due to intestinal metabolism of through a hepatic first pass effect. Example, hydralazine is metabolized by gut wall, and allopurinol is extensive metabolized in intestinal wall, and levodopa is metabolized by gut microbial flora. The first pass metabolism is propoxyphene or tripeptidyline and finasteride and propranolol and lidocaine. So the role of disease state, the rheumatoid arthritis, and aspirin is a drug of choice for arthritis would not be considered because half-life is 6 hours. But sustained release formulation is useful to alleviate morning stiffness, and dose is a problem. And sustained release tablet maintain therapeutic drug concentration over 8 to 10 hours. Peptic ulcer, belladonna alkaloids, and synthetic anticholinergic are used, and belladonna alkaloids are short acting. A spansel formulation contains belladonna alkaloids, maintain drug concentration to 8 to 12 hours. Angina pectoris nitroglycerin. So role of circadian rhythm. So the several biological process and disease influenced by circadian rhythm, acute microbial insufficiency 4 a.m. and epileptic seizure morning. So the side effect is sustained release formulation is useful in minimum the side effect of the drug, and side effect of a particular drug can be minimized by controlling its plasma concentration by using less total drug over the time course of therapy, example levodopa, and controlled release lower the incidence of drug induced dyskinesis. The lower the GI side effects, and aspirin, ferrous sulfate, and potassium chloride, nitrofurantoin, and margin of safety. So safety is determined by the therapeutic index T1 and TD50, ED by 50. So this is the complete session. This session is powered by the digital version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. And I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in comment box. I will resolve it your problem by the problem resolving class. Thank you, and thank you for the listening.